Hi, welcome back to Art by Brooke. For today's video, I am doing a rainbow kiss paint pour. So a kiss pour is where you do different colors in different cups, and then as you pour, the paint comes out together and ends up kind of combining, but being still slightly separated at the same time. I had hoped to do this video last month, but didn't quite get around to it, so we are doing it now. Let's get started. So I was just about to pour, and I really think I have too much paint for this size canvas, so I'm going to switch it out for one slightly bigger. So this is very interesting. It actually doesn't really look like a rainbow pour, more like a hot versus cold pour, because I think we lost some of the yellow and also a lot of the purple. So I think we kind of lose the effect of all of the colors in there together. But that being said, I think it's still really cool. It kind of looks like some sort of heat map for like a weather map or terrain or something like that. Or maybe an overhead shot of lava meeting water. Whatever it is, it's pretty interesting and not really what I'd usually do, but I really like it. I'm kind of disappointed that we didn't get the rainbow effect, but paint pouring is kind of always a little bit unexpected and you're always learning, and you could do the same pour 5 different times, 100 different times with the same exact colors and never get the same result. So I'm gonna let this sit for a little while and then we'll take a closer look. All right, let's take a closer look. So you can see a lot of little tiny cells throughout this. I think that kind of goes along with this type of paint, if I'm remembering correctly from my review video. This is not paint that I've used that much, but I'm kind of looking forward to testing it out using different techniques. And down here, see, there's some really cool definition with the red. And I wish we had a little bit more of that, but the red and the orange kind of meld together in here. So there's not a lot of definition in there, but up through here, it kind of looks velvety almost. And then this area is super pretty. I feel like it kind of looks like the start of a geode over here. And then down here, you see how this blue kind of merges with the orange and then fades over here into the orange and yellow. So overall, I think this is a really fun paint pour, and I definitely want to do more kiss pours in the future. I've done some in the past that I really loved and want to keep trying to recreate that. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Are there any colors you'd like to see in a future kiss pour? Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and click the bell so you get a notification every time I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day. So I wanted to do a little update because I pre-filmed this last night, and today as it's drying, unfortunately it is cracking. Or I guess maybe that's considered crazing? I'm not quite sure. So I think that the problem here is that I used a different white, so not this brand, and used that underneath. And I think that that is what's causing that issue here. Something about the formulas don't go together. Because I'm pretty sure there wasn't too much paint on here. But of course now it looks really thick because it's pulling away from the bottom layer. So yeah, that's a disappointment, but good to know. So I wanted to make sure I put this in here because I usually do want to test these pre-mixed pour paints with other colors. So I might have to do another smaller test on this just to make sure that I didn't make any other mistakes somewhere else, but good to know for now. I'm pretty disappointed in this, but everything's a learning experience, so I will just go forward from here.